Oh, most gracious and holy Father, we thank you for today's broadcast, Father. Move by your spirit on today. Touch the lives of the listeners. Touch my life, God. Be glorified. Lord, I thank you, Father, for this continual week on this week, Father. Lord, I thank you, Father, for as we are in a brand new season of this Christmas time, this family time, this holy time. Lord, I just thank you, Father, for today's broadcast, this encore presentation, God. Lord, I just thank you, Father, for it all. Lord, we lift your name on high and we glory and magnify your name, because it is in you that we live, move, and have our being. It is in your Son Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Y'all, let's get started for an all-new broadcast, an all-new encore presentation of The Arch 3 Show. Join me after the introduction just for a brief minute, all right? We'll be back with more of The Arch 3 Show.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
From North Carolina, it's the RH3 Show.
I wasn't scared to go over the edge.
Look, I do this for nobody but my co-host. Because God first, then my co-host.
I've been doubted, I've been counted out, I've been overlooked.
Because your listeners are, you know, international, they're worldwide.
RH3 Show starts right now.
I gotta pray because he said me. I said he paid for me at Calvary. I'm gonna dance and there's no stopping me. Don't ever change because I got victory.
What is going on, everybody? Hope you all are doing well on today. I am doing great. Thank you all for joining me for an all new encore presentation of the RH3 Show. I thank you all for joining me on today. Y'all, we got a great broadcast on today. We got some Christmas music, a lot of Christmas music playing on today, and a lot of other music. I got Nina Taylor. She's here. I'm going to do my inside scoop of the Rufus News in just a minute, right after I finish talking to you all. Instead of me waiting for I do live, we got that Real Talk with Rufus discussion, how to maintain your singleness during the holidays. I got that. That's an encore that played a couple years ago. And so, yeah, I got that for you all. And, so I'm gonna go ahead and, drop that introduction right now.
Gotta catch up on the news regarding politics, or if you want to know news about the TV, movies, sports, and or the music industry, be it if it's in gospel or any other entertainment genre, well, it is time for the Inside Scoop of the Rufus right here on the RH3 Show.
And so, yes, that is the introduction for the Inside Scoop of the Rufus News. So, congratulations to Brittany Griner. She has been released from the Russian. Detention. And for exchange for the Russian arms dealer, Victor Bout. And so, yeah. Nazir Wiggins, his mother is talking. And so I hope that don't sabotage what the Cabo Six is doing and how they are trying to hide or whatever. But they still need to get justice for our girl, Shanquilla. Shanquilla's mother had an interview, I believe. I haven't watched it. I watched part of it from a YouTuber's channel. So, yeah. Shanquilla need her justice. And I told y'all a couple weeks ago that Shanquilla's somebody, two people are being detained but it has not been in the news media here, and they got up to 20 days for all of that to be settled, looked over, dealt with, you know, or whatever. Then also, it's private records now, but as soon as the treaty or whatever, I don't know the governmental terms and legal terms for all of that, but once it, you know, reach another level or they get into something, whatever, all of that will become public records, and then we'll find out who has been locked up, this, that, and the third. And so, yeah. Kirstie Alley, she, of course, died privately this week, and we found out that she had died of colon cancer. So, yeah. I also have some, if y'all are in, we, of course, we family oriented here on the Arch 3 show. So I have some, great, where is it at? And I'll repeat these later on, later into the month, but, I have some black, some great black holiday movies that you all can watch with your families during this Christmas movies. Some top black Christmas movies that you all can watch this month. The Sound of Christmas. And all of these are, wait a minute, this one is premiering tonight on BET. And so that is December 9th. Yeah. Tonight at 9 p.m. on BET. Another one is Holiday Heartbreak. And that stars Lisa Ray McCoy. I cannot pronounce the name because her name is blurry. Mary Am Bazar, Michael Collier, Country Wayne, and AJ Johnson. Okay. And also A Rich Christmas starring Bill Bellamy, Brandy Evans, Tyler Abram, Denise Boutier, and Vanessa Williams. Another one is The First Noel, and that's her name, Noel, N-O-E-L-L-E. That look like that's going to be a good one, a BET Plus original. Y'all, I'm at home, and so I told y'all I've been resting, convalescing, doing all the rigmarole, or what have you, so bear with me. That had a, there might be an Amazon, or whatever, or weather alert. The Christmas Party Crashes. That don't say who that stars, but anyway, let's move on. A New Orleans Noel. That's look like it stars, okay. Keisha Knight Pulliam and her husband, Brad James, with Tim Reed and Patti LaBelle. And a next one is A Miracle Before Christmas. Okay, these look good. And they are all BET Plus movies. And some of them are on BET. So, yeah, watch these. These look like they're going to be good. And so if you have BET Plus on your app, watch them. I admonish you to. And so, yeah, these are holiday movies. And I will try to repeat those or find some other new ones closer to the middle or the end of, well, the middle of the month, and so y'all can watch them. All right, here's Nina Taylor with her portion of This Week in Gospel. No, I'm gonna take a couple music breaks, and then Nina Taylor, then a music break, then I'm gonna do the Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and maybe after that we'll probably be closing out the show. All right, and I'll come back and close out the show. All right, more of the Arch 3 shows coming up next. Y'all, I'm still sore a bit, and so I'm just, you know, thanking God for my total healing, y'all. All right, be back with more.
Joy he brings, won't you listen? King Jesus, where it lay.
Want a free subscription to be a part of our live listening audience? Download one of the major podcast platforms, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, Amazon Music, Spotify, iHeartRadio, TuneIn Radio, Radio Public, and more. And search The RH3 Show, or you can tell your home device, Alexa, or Hey Google, play the latest RH3 Show on Amazon Music, or one of your favorite podcast platforms. And then subscribe. You'll get all new content as well as access to previously aired broadcasts to listen to, download, and also to share to one of your contacts. We'd love for you to be a part of our family. So subscribe today.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast and info on how to listen or watch from where you are, please visit therh3show.com.
Here we go. Come on, everybody. Put your hands together.
Focus your eyes on Jesus.
we're gonna have some fun right here. Y'all remember James Brown, right? Yeah. Come on. Hit me. Dance with me, all right? Now, y'all know James had to do it two times. You know he had to do it two times. Here we go, hit me two times. Hey!
Holidays. I'm Nina Taylor. Here's your gospel news for this week. A former member of the revered gospel group commissioned, Michigan-based singer Marvin Sapp embarked on a solo career in the mid-90s. He has issued a string of chart-topping hits. His crossover appeal has even landed him 11 Grammy nominations. Recruited by the legendary group commissioned, Marvin Sapp recorded with the group until their dissolution in 1995 and then began his own solo career with a self-titled album the following year. Born and raised in Grand Rapids, Michigan, Marvin Sapp debuted with Commission in the early 90s. He recorded the commissioned albums Number 7 and Matters of the Heart after Hammond and Williams left. He recorded the group's final album, 1996 Irreplaceable Love. By that time, Marvin Sapp had signed a solo contract too in March of 1996. We saw the release of his debut album. The album reunited him with former Commission mate Fred Hammond, who produced the LP and featured gospel hits like Calling Me and In His Presence. His sophomore effort, Grace and Mercy, appeared in May of 1997, followed 2 years later by Nothing Else Matters. After a short absence from the music scene, Marvin Sapp reappeared with I Believe on Wild Gospel 2002. Diary of a Psalmist appeared in 2003, Be Exalted 2005, and The Gold-Selling Thirsty in 2007. Here I Am debuted higher in the Billboard charts than any other gospel album in 50 years, arrived in 2010, and was followed by I Win in 2012, which hit number one on the Billboard Top Gospel charts. 2015 saw the release of Sapp's 10th studio long player, the chart-topping You Shall Live in 2017. The song Listen, later on appearing on his 11th album, Close, in September of that year, and then he issued Chosen Vessel in 2020. 2 years later, the release of the album Substance, his 15th studio album. Christmas is celebrated around the world on December 25th and is both a sacred religious holiday and a worldwide cultural and commercial phenomenon. People around the world have been observing its traditions and practices, which are both religious and secular in nature. Popular customs include exchanging gifts, decorating Christmas trees, attending church, and sharing meals with family and friends. December 25th, Christmas Day, has been a federal holiday in the United States since 1870. In Nigeria, because it's the most populated nation in all of Africa and because of its large economy, Nigeria is not only large, it also has land of great diversity containing within itself nearly 500 distinct ethnic groups, each of which generally has its own language and culture. The largest groups are the Yoruba, the Igbo, and the Hausa, but even these make up relatively a small percentage of Nigeria's 180 million people. About 48.3% of people who live in Nigeria are Christians, with 48.9% being Muslim and a very very small percent still holding on to other African beliefs. Christmas is a public holiday in Nigeria. There are some denominations in Nigeria that do not accept December 25th as the true date of the birth of Christ, and indeed it's almost certainly not, but most of these still participate in the celebrations, observing simply the fact that he was born, regardless of the day on which it happened. In Nigeria, families will gather together on Christmas Eve to throw a party that lasts all night. Those who live in the big cities often travel back to the small country villages to attend such parties. Older relatives, like parents and grandparents especially, tend to reside in the villages, and it's customary to gather where your ancestors live instead of where the siblings live. After a long night of celebrating, most Nigerians go to church services on Christmas morning. They thank God for the gift of his son and for the blessings of the past year. Also, the church choir will often go caroling at the homes of the church members sometime during the Christmas season. Here's a list of the top 10 Christmas carols of all time. Number 10, O Holy Night. 9, Go Tell It on the Mountain. 8, God Rest You, Merry Gentlemen. 7, Joy to the World. 6, O Christmas Tree. 5, Children, Go Where I Send Thee. 4, Angels We Have Heard on High. 3, Jingle Bells. 2, We Wish You a Merry Christmas. And the number one Christmas carol of all times is Deck the Halls. Well, that's your top 10 Christmas carols of all time, how Christmas is celebrated in Nigeria, and your gospel news. I'm Nina Taylor. Happy holidays. Let's get back to more great gospel music on this great station.
Y'all, that song Nina Taylor mentioned, that children go where I send thee, that was, we sung that at my church when we were younger. Children go where I send thee, how shall I send thee? Well, I should send thee one by one, one for the little bitty baby, wrapped in swaddling clothing, lying in the manger, born in Bethlehem. Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send? I love that song. Here's my favorite song, y'all. I love this song. I played it earlier this week, but here it is again. I love it. It is by All Nations Church. That is Apostle Matthew Stevenson's church. Oh God, y'all, I love it. It's Cry Out. Here it is. I'll be back to close out the show then, and then music will play. Then I'll play the Real Talk with Rufus. Then I'll close out. Peace.
Of a horrible pit, you snatched me out of a horrible pit, you snatched me out of a horrible pit, you are the Lord of the destiny. Come on, put those hands together if you know that when you cry out, the Lord hears you.
righteous cry out, he will deliver. The righteous cry out, he will deliver. Say,
the righteous cry out,
he will.
Yes, you are.
You're listening to The RH3 Show. You can visit my website at therh3show.com. I'm Rufus, host of The RH3 Show. I've been the host, founder, visionary, content creator, executive producer, and many other titles of this brand for well over 10 years. During my tenure, I've been blessed to join the platform of radio and podcasting that is currently nationally and internationally syndicated in well over 13 countries. As I continue to work my gift that God has so richly blessed me with, I realize that it has been you, my day one family, and also my co-host family, which also is my listening audience, who have gotten me to this point. Out of many years of being in broadcasting and journalism, for each level that I've reached, and as I continue to climb this ladder of success, it only serves me right to give you better content and also better quality of material. And by doing that, it costs. We're looking forward to getting new and up-to-date audio equipment, video equipment to revamp the Arch 3 Show content on YouTube, to attend award shows, etc. So if the Arch 3 Show have been a blessing to you, which it shows, and we know that you have been a blessing to us, which it shows, please consider sponsorship. I pray that God touches your heart and give you the nod to sow a seed into this broadcast. The fruit speaks, right? It does. Even if you haven't listened to the broadcast and feel led to be a blessing, I thank you in advance. If you will, please begin by sowing a financial seed of any amount. I pray that God will richly bless you and it all comes back to you 100-fold. Just like the story in the Bible, the one that gave little was much more bigger than any one that had given. The show has been a blessing to me and has been a release for me. I love what I do. And as I say on every broadcast, know that I love you for real. And always remember to live every day, laugh at every moment, and to love God, love yourself, and love other people beyond words. I take this broadcast to heart in everything that I do. In everything that I do, I take it to heart, and what I do, I put you all, my listening audience, to mind, all right? So please go to thearch3show.com and click on the sponsorship tab, and from there you will see many ways to give. You can give by Zelle, Cash App, GoFundMe, or any other areas that you can see on there, all right? So please go to thearch3show.com and click on sponsorship, all right? This is going to be a humbling experience for me, and I will thank you in advance for any amount of seed that you sow and plant into the life of the Arch 3 Show brand. I love you for real, and I thank you in advance for your financial seed. Thank you, and God bless. The website again is www.thearch3show.com. Thank you so much for your seed, and God bless. This is real life. We show real love and we also have real, non-judgmental conversations. All from a Christian male perspective. Not all of them, just mine. So let's have an open-minded conversation. It's the Real Talk with Rufus, right here on the RH3 Show. Today we're going to be discussing and talking about how singles can maintain their relationship during the holiday. Relationship and you're single? Well, I mean, you're not married. So, you know, you, of course, if you don't have a significant other, I can see, you know, you don't have a relationship. We're going to be talking about that if you want to get technical. We're going to talk about that, you know, we have relationships with friends, families, church members, whoever. So we're going to discuss all of that and, you know, get it in with you all on today. And so the first, what we're going to get into, the first one is, I'm going to give you a prerequisite. The holidays is one of the best times of the year. It is great. It is a great time to be surrounded by the loved ones who matters the most. However, y'all, holidays approaching can be also a daunting time and task for singles like you. Whoever listening, if you're single, and me, reminding you of your lack of a significant other. However, being single does not have to feel like being lonely. Here are a few tips, and these are according to MeritandYoung.com. But I'm gonna converse, give you my opinion, my commentary in between these, and here are some tips and advice on how to get through the holidays if you are. Sorry, y'all. If you are single, number one, volunteer. Whatever thy hands find to do, y'all, do it. Not only before the holidays, but especially during the holidays. You got organizations here that is doing holiday gift grabs, food giveaways, gift giveaways, fundraisers or whatever. Go out and volunteer. Go out and volunteer and, be there for your community and be involved in social change, y'all. Be involved in social change and, get out there and get in the hustle and the bustle of volunteering and being, what's the word I'm thinking of? Philanthropic. Be a philanthropy and get into organizations and nonprofits just give out, just be a help. You can't do that if you have when I say significant other, if you have a friend, put on quotes, a guy friend, ladies, female friend, fellas, and y'all really close, but you're not dating, you're not in a relationship, go hang out. Use this time to, volunteer. Your church, during the week, during the day, if you have an office that's open, go out and have fun and go out and volunteer. Do whatever, go to that pastor, go to your pastor, say, Pastor, I want to do something during the week. Is it okay? I want to fund it because, your funds may be tight or whatever, going to other parts of the community and say, look, I want to give this. I want to do this for the children. I want to do this. I want to do community service. I want to volunteer during, the holidays. I don't have nobody. I want to volunteer. You can. The holidays are all about giving. So what better way to spend the holidays by giving back? It helps get out your own head and when you can stop to think about the needs of others. Many places can use the help of people during the season. Volunteering a homeless shelter, like I said, donating toys, gift wrapping at the mall, helping out at the children's hospital. These are great ways to give back, leaving you with a rewarding feeling. And I seen where this one church is doing a, quote, wrap party. A wrap party. You bring gifts, unwrapped gifts, wrapping paper, tape, scissors, and y'all come out and wrap gifts. And the gifts that you're bringing are staying there and are going to be presented to others, the holidays. I mean, for Christmas or whatever. Yeah, so volunteer. Volunteer. Just volunteer. I love it. Number two, spending time with family. Take the time to go and spend time with that relative you may have not seen in a while. They may be thrilled that you are in company and create more memories. Starting out with Thanksgiving, go with grandma's house in a week before Thanksgiving, a couple days before Thanksgiving. Go spend time with her. Help out with dinners. Help out with preparing dinners. I may have a brunch before, the family comes. When the family comes, be the host of these parties. Be the host of these events. Be the host of these gatherings. And just go out and parlay and have fun. Seriously, there's nothing like being single in the holidays, y'all. It's really, you can do whatever you want to do. You don't have to, go home early. You don't have to, take your children. If you're single and have children, it's another different story. But still, if you're single with no children, I'm ready to be married, but hey, I'm gonna miss it. But hey, it is what it is. Number three, single group outings. Gather all of your single friends and make it a singles outing. Whether it be a short trip, a day of shopping, taking a painting class, or holiday dinner, I'm sure your single friends will appreciate this fun thought, and you could be helping them from being a single slug. Go, y'all. I love it. I love doing anything group with friends and singles and whatever. I would love to do a singles trip or whatever, and just go out and just have fun and just enjoy yourself and just be catered to, you know. I would love to do that before I get married. I would love it. Be celebrated in my singleness, you know. Number four, decorating. Deck your places out the holiday, out in holiday gear is a great way to put yourself in holiday spirit. It is also a great way to get your creativity out, making it fun and festive. Decorate. You know, with me singles, y'all, I used to do it and I might do it again this year, but, you know, I decorate my house and people come out, look, hey, you got all these decorations, you don't have no family, what, excuse me? I'm getting in the holiday spirit before, you know? Just because you don't do it, that don't mean I don't have to do it. Playing me. Number five, throwing a holiday party and gathering friends and family for a holiday party is a good way to get everyone together. There are a myriad of holiday theme parties for throwing friends together. Friendsgiving gathering, to an ugly sweater Christmas party, to a cookie baking party, or to having Christmas movie night, or any idea should do. And if you have your guests, bring a plus one. Who knows? You may meet a special someone in the midst of it all. Of what? Coming up next, I'm going to come back with part two of this. And singles, how to remain singles during the holiday. Keep it locked here on the RTWR Show. Be back in a minute. Everything you love about The RTWR Show is now on our website, therTWRShow.com. Adore You Fashion Fix, the Scripture of the Week, Cooking with Soul Recipes, Just for the Family, A Plan of Salvation and Rededication, Sponsorship Information, Shop RTWR, and a whole lot more just for you. See it first, see it now, only at therTWRShow.com. Number six in singles, how you can deal with yourself and your life and everything else during the holidays. And number seven and last would be also, join some type of play or something, a Christmas play, you know, just have fun. Do you, and you know, just don't let it be in a time to where, you know, you feel bad, like, oh God, I'm single and I don't have nothing to do during the holidays. No, let's not get into the slumps and dumps of, you know, the holidays and we're single. We can't do that, y'all. We can't do that. Here are six daily self-care practices for our Be Positive message for today. Number one, do something that makes you happy. Number two, rest. Number three, connect with someone you love. Four, meditate, reflect, and breathe. Five, go outside and get some fresh air. And number six, get creative.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit therH3Show.com.
We're out of here, you all. Thank you all so much for joining me for this encore and best of week. I love you all for real. We're still contemplating on seeing how next week is going to roll, but I love you for real, and I will see you all next week, preferably on how it's going to go. But I'll talk to you all soon, and I'll see you all next time right here on The Arch 3 Show. Follow us on our social media platforms at The Arch 3 Show on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat, and also on my personal Facebook page for you all at Official RH3. All right, I'll talk to y'all soon. Peace.
Switch my old status, that's from sinner to saint. As winners, we can't live by the picture they paint. Because they know that all the inner is tainted. So we must live out our lives with a sense of restraint. Which means, do I live and we ain't? We are controlled by the flesh, we're depicted in sway. And pray without a quitter's complaint. And being able to turn down your dinner at 8. Because the price that he paid for me gave to me my freedom. So I'm not in slavery. Christ made a way for me. Grace me then paid for me. A way back to God through the life that he gave for me. And made me able to switch. Our lives were in darkness. Then he came with a switch. So we don't walk like we used to. Talk like we used to. Call us with honor and he'll do it for you too. Yeah.
I know I gotta praise him now. Praise him because he called me to switch. Go ahead. Cause I know I gotta give it up. Anybody wanna come and praise the Lord?
See you later.
Cause I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night, good night.